In this video, I show you the medial synovial fold of the posterior cruciate ligament. Hold on for a second, the what? Even if you didn't know about the structure, you didn't do a lot wrong anyways. It's not a very important structure, although it's quite frequently visible on knee MRI. So we all know the typical morphology of the PCL here on your sagittal view, with this nice black signal intensity, sharp contours, no fraying, and on your coronal view you can also easily see the posterior cruciate ligament, and we are talking the medial border of the PCL. So have a look here at the medial border while I'm scrolling through. This is how you would probably think it looks on every normal knee MRI. Now, let me pull up a case with a medial synovial fold. So here's the case, and you can see on your sagittal you still have the normal PCL appearance, nice black signal intensity, and nothing really to see here on your sagittals. The sequence you can see the medial synovial fold the best is your coronal view. And now, if we go through from anterior to posterior, we can see the origin here. And this is the medial side, and now we're going through, and suddenly you can see this black structure here at the medial border of the PCL. Now let me make this a little bit bigger. So this is the PCL running through, that's the insertion. Let me go back again, and here we have this black structure interposing between the medial femoral condyle and the tibial head. So, and now there are a few things that come to mind first when you see this, or if you see this the first time. And one is it actually the PCL that is impinged here? The second possibility would be, is it displaced meniscus? So is it a bucket handle tear or anything of that kind? But no, we can check here. We have a very normal appearing medial meniscus. The volume of the substance is perfectly fine, the posterior root is looking fine, the posterior horn is looking fine. So I can show you this here. So it's not a displaced meniscal fragment. And this is a medial synovial fold of the PCL. In one study they actually assessed also histopathology of the medial synovial fold, and it's actually not part of the PCL, of the ligament itself, but it's part of the synovium around the PCL. So basically there are two important concepts here. If the medial synovial fold is very small or absent even, it doesn't matter at all, it doesn't have any mechanical implications during knee movement. However, if the medial synovial fold of the PCL is large and extending into the medial compartment itself, it is believed, at least by some authors, that it might actually cause an impingement. Now let's go back to our case here. We have again this medial synovial fold of the PCL, and if you look closely you can appreciate that the cartilage of the medial femoral condyle here in this central aspect of the joint is not very crisp anymore. So there is some irregularity on the surface of the cartilage and even some signal changes within the cartilage itself visible on both sequences here on the normal PD and the fat-saturated PD sequence. In studies assessing this medial synovial fold of the PCL, there is a grading system that uses a classification from type A, B, and C, but don't use it, okay? It's useless, it doesn't help you in your clinical routine. If you have a large or very prominent medial synovial fold, just give the impression of a prominent structure there and don't even try to make the conclusion that it's actually causing an impingement. Now let me show you this case here. I first scroll through, and what you can see, we have a medial synovial fold here of the PCL, a very prominent one, and now here things start to get tricky. Look at the middle portion of the medial meniscus, there is a tear and the substance is somewhat reduced, so we are thinking about a pocket handle tear. And actually here there is actually a displaced meniscal fragment into the intercondylar notch here. And if you're running through, this is still one part of this displaced meniscus fragment, and you can also see it here. So this sling here, this is a part of a bucket handle tear that is displaced here from this portion here. However, our posterior horn is more or less okay. And if you scroll through, this here is now the medial synovial fold of the PCL, and it's not part of this incomplete bucket handle tear, which is further anteriorly. So this is a situation where even if you don't know about it, you will not get it wrong. You would probably just misinterpret this as maybe an additional meniscus fragment, or just think that it's in continuation with the other displaced meniscus substance here. So it's not really an issue, but just keep a lookout here and be happy that you hopefully have learned something new today. Although the medial synovial fold of the PCL is a normal structure and most frequently not clinically relevant, I still believe it's helpful as a radiologist to know about it, and the next time you see it, you save yourself a lot of time instead of investigating what could it be and so on. You simply know it's a synovial fold. It can be there, it can be small, it can be large, and if it's large, it might be symptomatic, which needs clinical correlation. Please give this video a like and also make sure to subscribe to my channel.
Do it!